All right, sorry, y'all. I was getting ready. What up, what it do? Talk to screeners that come through. I was getting ready and shit. A little late. No, I'm on time, but woke up like 15 minutes ago. I got like about 40 minutes. I'm gonna do it outside. Just trying to make sure I'm consistent for y'all. What up? Somebody wanna chat with you before you start your auditions. Somebody wanna chat with me before you start your auditions. What up, Lotus? My bad. I'm about to walk out. Hey, y'all, we gotta get to this first box. The second box. Let's get to the second box. We're gonna start in about 25 minutes once we get to the second box. I can't believe I actually went to sleep, though. Usually it'd be a struggle trying to go to sleep, but I went to sleep, though. Chris Michaels, I have to talk to real quick. Who is Chris Michaels? What up, Ari Rose? TKO, please. TKO, I have to talk to you. Huh? Stop talking to me.
TKO, what's up, my friend?
That's who I was talking about. That was trying to get contact with you.
Contact with you? Like, you a lawyer or something?
How are you, TKO?
Like, I'm about
He's a comedian.
I didn't get in trouble, did I?
No, you're good.
Okay,
I just
okay,
wanted
cool.
to change from one king to another type shit, no fucking cap. Even though people hate on you, you get your shit, and I respect it.
Oh, that's all I love, bro. That's all I love. What's up, late night?
I'm like, get late night on this stuff. If you'll just give me 1 second, I put something together for you.
For me? What? Hold on, what's going on?
You ready?
What's up?
First of all, hit the fucking song. Give me 1 sec, TKO.
Okay. What?
So much you would think of Jesus Christ moments. I feel crucified, don't want to lose or die. Girl says she love me, bitch, you a lie. Who's the guy chain around his neck like a noose tie? Wearing designer, your boo supply. Oh, Capone is the answer, no nigga is real as me. Fucking you niggas ain't feeling me. All these diamonds be lighting me up like a Christmas tree. Santa Claus just want to chill with me, gang. Ooh, all these diamonds on me, baby. More whips and chains and slavery. Now bitches want to pay me.
I just woke up. So, even if you're not on money record, you can do it consistently. So let me know if you can do that and if you can officially do that position. That'd be a big help. That's pretty my biggest help. You know, a lot of people like to call, what can I do for you? I I tell people all the time, that's one of the things you could do. I need somebody to come like consistent and you could do that. That's really a big thing.
TKO, you can hear your song, right?
Yeah. What it do? What it do?
I really do love that song, but
I appreciate
you're
it.
My fucking hero, bro.
He got the same dashiki. He got the same dashiki. That's what
I'm
gonna do, man.
I got diamonds on me, baby. Diamonds on me, baby. I got 9 bitches and they gonna pay me. Type shit, no f- cap.
Already? Wait a minute. Hold on, man. That's what's up. That's what it do, man. I appreciate that. No, I do. I do appreciate the support. You new to the app or you been on the app for a minute?
Been on since like December 1st.
Oh, okay. Because they're like Chris Michaels. I'm like, there's a lot of people who know you. Evidently, there's a lot of people who know you and shit like that. It's crazy.
How'd you do a little comedy? Watching your live.
Oh, so you be in here. Okay, this what's up. I appreciate the love. What's you to do this?
Driving everyone crazy on this app. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to put 2 and 2 together. I think I heard some stuff about you. Yeah, so you be doing comedian stuff?
Yeah, usually every Wednesday and some stand-up in New York City.
Already, family. That's what's up. What's up? Are you from the West Coast? Is it light where you at right now, or are you on somewhere else?
New York, like near Queens.
Oh, you right in Queens, but yeah, it's still light out here. I'm about to probably do this, probably audition out here in this West tonight. But yeah, bro, man, let me follow you, man. It's all love. And I'm about to do this poly auditions right now, so I'm trying to get this box. I'm trying to get everybody together because, you know, they don't be gifted when I'm not focused and stuff. So I'm trying to get everybody together for tonight, man. But yeah.
He's entertaining, guys, so make sure you gift him. Tap the screen, share the live, and don't sit there, man. If you can't throw a bean, the minimum you got to do is tap the screen for this man because he's got diamonds on his neck. And we love the diamonds. I like this song better than the Pepsi song.
Oh, you like it better than the Pepsi? Okay.
Yes. This is my favorite one. I actually, and this is crazy. I love myself some Melanated Queens as well, and I play this while I'm clapping cheeks.
Yeah, hey, you know what, though? You know, Pepsi is a bop, but that song is melodic. You know what I'm saying? I like melodic shit. So since it got like a melody to it, it got some emotion in it. I like it too. But you know, Pepsi and that song is way different from each other. But that's my latest song though, so I appreciate that. That's my latest music.
Well, keep doing you.
That's out there.
Yo, keep doing you and f those haters. You know. And I hope to link up with you in the future, and I'll let you get back to your auditions. Ladies, good luck.
I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that. Chris Michaels, man. Y'all follow Chris Michaels.
Thank you, TKO. All right,
much love, family. Let's go. Starting off with good vibes, man. Starting off with good vibes. For sure. Hold on, y'all. Give me a second. I'm trying to... It's light out here, too. All right. Is that how we started off, Armani? Is this how we started off? Thank you, baby. I appreciate it. So look, we halfway there already, man. We halfway there to that box, to that second box, and we're gonna get started tonight. I'm doing everything off the light. What's up, Catcorns? What's up, Carly? How you doing, baby? Where the grill at? Oh yeah. I forgot it. Y'all put me on. I just woke up literally like 15-20 minutes ago. Like 15-20 minutes ago. So y'all bear with me, man. I'm still like kind of rusty. I probably look like I just woke up, washed my face, put some oil on my face, threw on the clothes, and I came down. So, you know, I'm still, man, appreciate that, Chris Michaels. Appreciate that, family. He said, I'm gonna take two first names. Y'all niggas can't have shit. Too much. We're gonna have too much. Damn, I hit up a few people. I don't know who checked in with me. Polygyny King so far, too much. I hit up, hold on, man, because I don't want to say too much, but if not, I need Shu and Late Night to stay on the side, just in case. I don't want to tell y'all something and I got everybody here. So let me make sure that the first judges ain't going to be here, but I would love to have, you know, Late Night, Shu, You said what time? At 7:30. At 7:30. All right, we four shields and six treasures away. No, it's not a singing competition. Who's just trying to line up with me? All right, we got two people. Let me open up my queue.
Nikki Gale.
I can't see. I'm opening up this queue. Oh, what's up? Okay, Nikki. We got young Nicki Minaj up in here. What up? What are you doing?
I saw your live. Who was that guy?
Huh?
Who was that guy?
You look good today.
Thank you. Can you hear me?
No, I can't hear you.
Really? Okay, so I'm gonna have to get down and come back up. Okay. Bye. Can you?
I ain't got that Lil Rob album for you, bro. Got that Lil Rob. I can't do it right now. I don't feel like talking with the lips all night. I gotta get used to it off of camera first. I can't do it. All right, so look, let's go. Yeah, that girl right there. She different though, but you know, God still made her like God made all of us. So be nice. God still made her. He seen it fit for her to be here for some reason. All right, ID number, jump down. Can I keep ID number? All right, what's up, Viper? All right, tap the screenshot alive, man. Let's get a treasure box up in here if we can. What up, Viper? Can we get a treasure box? What's up, sweetie? Let's get to the second box real quick. If y'all got a DIY notify, y'all can hit that for me. What's up, Cat Coins? What up, Melly Rowe? Z Times, hold on. Judah. Oh, yes, indeed. We starting now. Yes, indeed. We start. Yes, indeed. We starting now. All right, so let me play some music while we're getting ready, man. We still on time, though. What's up, boss lady? What's up, sweetie? Thank you, baby. What's up, bad boy? All right, let's try this real quick.
Gotta find my joint up on this bitch. Miss you. Get it. Sticking to the code, all these hoes for the street. I put it in her nose, it's gonna make her pussy leak. Pussy niggas told ain't gonna wake up at this seat.
What's up, Mr. Swag? What's up, man?
But you can hear them niggas scream. I'm a hoe through phones, nigga. I'm a hoe through clothes. 20 carat ring, I put my fingers down her throat. If I lose a carrot, she might choke. I know she gon' swallow, she'll go. Big bad nigga, bring the racks in. Got the shooters in the corner, light a pack in. She think Christian's at it, bitch, she a track.
I ain't missin' swag.
That's that shit that get you put up at the station. And the model's still the same. Fire like I won the championship game. You know these hoes hurt me, they gon' fuck for a name. I put her on the game, she get fucked for a chain. Got your girl in this bitch, she's trying on this dick. I got self in this bitch, turn up in this bitch. Everybody hurts in this bitch, you married in this bitch. All these corners on me, baby, you know it's game time. Frank friend, I'm bitch, you tell me at the same time. I'm a different nigga, no, we not the same kind. You can have that look, bitch, you ain't mine.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm dope, dealer selling dope, is you like that? Kicking doors, kicking in doors, is you like that? Young dope, nigga selling lows, is you like that? All 24, you won't go as you like that. Niggas from the bottom really like that. Stepping in Balenciaga if you like that. Pop another bottle if you like that.
Top of screen.
These niggas talking out of their neck, put no coughing out of your mouth.
Starting 10 minutes, 11 minutes.
Selling dope as you like that.
Let's
kicking doors, kicking.
Hey man, I'm a grateful nigga. But when I see somebody like Strawberry come up here, don't throw no motherfucking free ass gift. You're not a free ass gift type of girl. You be playing. Don't be throwing them little cheap ass gifts, because that's not how I look at you. I look at you as somebody that's gonna come through with the 1-2s. Even if it's like a treasure, but not a free motherfucking gift. But I appreciate the gift, but I don't appreciate it. Thank you, but no thank you. What's up, Hot Coco? How you doing?
So for some reason, I can't go on live on my other phone. Can you hear me?
Did anybody ask you?
No, I'm saying.
What's up?
Can you hear me?
What's up, Strawberry? What's going on? I can't hear it's her fucking. Hold on, she cutting you out. God damn. Hold on, we gonna pray for your Wi-Fi. All right, now what you saying, baby? I couldn't hear shit you said.
You trying to crack the whip on my pockets? Get up out my pockets.
Well, get up out them exclusive free item gifts, loyalty tickets and shit.
It lights the room up, so I do throw those to help light the room up and get it going, and then I do throw gifts on you. So no, you do know, everything counts.
No, you do. And I appreciate you. And you know, how you doing this evening in Ace Time?
I'm good. How are you? I'm about to let you go. I'm about to let what's name get back up here so she can bother everybody. Where's she at? Where's Coco at? Come back, Coco.
Thank you, baby. Thank you.
Goodbye. Bye. Goodbye.
I knew you had it in you one day. No, I'm playing. Let me stop playing on her top. Thank you, baby. I appreciate you. What's up, Leo? What's up, Tambra? Appreciate the love. Appreciate the love from up above. All right. We just need, how much we need? We almost there. We got 7 minutes left. What's up, Tambra? Thank you, baby. I appreciate you, Tambra. I appreciate you. Let's go.
All my exes, they gon' tell you I'm a real nigga. Really? I don't double back on hoes, but I can still hit them.
Cool.
They know I don't make excuses when I'm dealing with them. If he ain't spinning,
you say you wanna join the party? Are you a female? Yeah, hold on. Who's this to ask that? Yeah, just get in the what's the name? Just come up. It's not the drip idol, it's the poly auditions to join my poly family. So if that's what you want to do, yeah, just get in there. Thank you, y'all. Appreciate it.
And I'll be swimming in your ocean.
Get us out of the queue.
Super soldier. No, you ain't stressing on these hoes. You got your hookah going. I might surprise you with vacations. Don't know where we going. When you get home, I'm trying to taste it. Get to licking on.
Pick you up from JSX and get the kissing on. I can't wait till we get home. You can sit it on me. I don't want you to have it, so I bought it. It's not tricking on you. Ass poking in your dress. Loving how it's feeling on you. Smoking gas hit my chest. It smell like an engine running. At the house, we bored as fuck. Let's take a trip or something. You gotta work, don't give a fuck. Say you quit or something. Run out Celine with hella shit. We not stealing nothing. Suck it while I drive. Fuck it, make me park. I can have you in that Benz if you play it smart. Put you in the big Javinci's, not the baby shark. 50 inches to your ass, you got my middle part.
They gon' tell you I'm a real nigga. I don't double back on hoes, but I can still hit them. They know I don't make excuses when I'm dealing with
them. We almost there. Alright, let's get these views up to 2K, y'all. Let's get these views up to 2K. Let's get up to the second box. 222. Let's get up to the second box. Let's get these views up to 2K. Let's share to at least two people. If not, to two social medias like Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Your friends on here, if y'all can share to everybody. And if you got a DIY notify, hit a DIY notify right now. Three lines. From three lines at the bottom, three lines. And check and see if you got a DIY notify.
Everybody in the place, don't you see? Ride at the temple with the mud in my cup. In the hold of the year in my pocket. I put it in their face, making haters all look. There's so many jealous, I don't know where to look. I'm screaming at my partner, man, this bitch is.
What up, Nunu? How you doing, baby?
That's ready to bone. She got a room at the Victorian and she's all alone. It's early in the day, I'd have me later on. Put a number in my phone, she and I look alone. Back with my clique, standing on the seawall. Got music up loud.
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. Okay, can you send it to me? To the person that's texting? What up, Sherry? What's up, Sherry? I'm about to say, what's up, Sherry? What's up, Shells? Thank you. Bless you. Where we at right now? We ain't even over 1K. Let's get the shares up. Let's get the taps up. So, look, when I say let's share the live, I'm not just saying, like, let's share the live just, like, on some... A normal thing. I need everybody to actually share the live for me, and I need y'all to actually tap the screen for me, and I need y'all to actually send beans so we can get higher on that heat list. Send heat gifts, send family gifts that they get the heat list up, and I'm gonna appreciate you. I appreciate you even for thinking about it, but I don't appreciate you for not doing it. So if we can get everybody to get this room popping so we can get started and we can record it and all that good shit. All right. Thank you. What up, Cat Coins? Welcome back late night. We're gonna try to get this shit going. What's up, Scarface? What it do? We need two more luxury cars, y'all. Get started. We got 3 minutes.
I bet everything I could never select was broke, could never forget. Them kills push up when they get my consent, they hit you, they get a percent. This girl straight from Berlin, I'll never forget. I spent 810. I ain't trying to argue too much. Niggas life savings, I'm making too much. I'm in the fast car doing two stunts. Before I do that, pre-roll with 2 guns. Hey, I got a need for speed. 20 they gave me, but that's ain't guaranteed. Fuck them, got off the leash. You try to stop it, but that shit on never see. I told the captain, I beat the odds, it wasn't supposed to happen. Took off on y'all, now we overlapping. Confidence telling it, I was just tapping the pedal. OZ loud like a bitch in the ghetto. I spent 3,000 as much on loud. Chain on bound, this bitch right town. Big ass man, fuck hoes on the couch. With a fat old ass, they'll fuck her mouth. Hey, some made nigga take no orders. Black R8, no transporter. Leaving the puddle wherever I kick it. Dripping the jury way over a quarter. And the exhaust course, I get that money, ain't no kind of slaughter. All type of ways, there's really no order. Ribbon up pipe seal, LED lights, offset wheels, offset holes, cut all glass. Here's your thing, I'm thinking grills. I ain't trying to sit on you gas. I just let Michigan ass. Bought everything about sass. You know I never did sad. I use a stem for the souls. Then I go up with a soul.
Some bitches I hate, I met. Hit up my jeweler, freeze my neck. 11 left, I'ma get Louis the rest. I bet everything I could never select. Was broke, could never forget. Them killers push up when they get my consent. They hit you, they get a percent.
You ready for the night, Hazel?
I'll never forget. I spent 810. I ain't trying to argue too much. Niggas life savings, I'm making too much. I'm feeling fast, got to do it too fast. Before I do that, pre-roll a few guns. I gotta need the speed. 20 they get me, but that's ain't guaranteed.
Everybody that's coming in live right now, make sure y'all go get y'all drinks, y'all beverages, you know what I'm saying, before y'all sit down, go use the restroom, you know what I'm saying, if you got a bad bitch to your right, or if you got a handsome man to your left, you know what I'm saying, make sure y'all chilling tonight, you know what I'm saying, you know why y'all in the arena, you know what I'm saying, everybody, yo, we kicking it right now. You know, if we drinking, what you thinking? What's up, Hazel? It's about to be right now. I'm trying to get to this second box. So we about to start doing it pretty soon. All right, baby? My nigga Polygyny King said he need 10 more minutes. So we just, you know, we just playing about here. I got to get to the second box anyway. We right here anyway. So it's pretty soon, though. All right, baby? And thank you for being on time. All right.
Okay.
All right, bye. My little light, bright friend. What up with you? Miami. I can't wait till I get me a dark girl that's dark as night so it can just gag the whole app. Y'all be scared of me just like the snow bunnies be scared of me. Give me white, like Chris Michaels. Or give me something dark, black, Hershey, chocolate. You know what I'm saying? Stop being scared.
Now that's how you're supposed to shoot.
What's
from
up, Melanin?
On, that's how you shoot!
What it do? You ain't scared? They say that, but they ain't never show up for the...
Higher there, young extra bigger boss. Higher there. You are the chosen one.
What up, baby?
Ass.
What up, baby?
Hey. I love to wear Gucci P.
I love it.
New traps excite me. The way I hear, they'll try to indict me. Hold on me. Don't try to fight me. All she wanna do is fight. And give me traps still. Rub my back.
Rub my back.
And feed me fat meals. I clap still. If you say the wrong thing, P, it can get that real. Mr. Big Bands, don't play about the trap. Bitch, you on IG cool, but you a catfish. Fuck me. I can put a wig on a pig, nigga. I'll check $100,000 out of her, you dig, nigga. Rich nigga, be a bitch, nigga, I can't do that. No. Gelato was a cool pack, but we blew that. Baby, I'm a full-blown yimp, I thought she knew that.
She had a chance with me, then she blew that.
The cash in your city, a mirror for the drip, I'm $1 million yimp. I'm rich, and I don't play with no dumb bitch. You here to work, not to have fun, bitch. Had dreams to be rich, and then my dreams came true. She had dreams of paying me, and then her dreams came true. Check trap, I start moonwalking. Keep talking, well, pick ass out a new coffin.
Let's go!
Maserati start barking, she's in harmony.
They gotta change that new treasure, they gotta change that treasure box name to Lexi Bay.
Until I'm in my coffin, if I die, bury all my dreams, my car's in my coffin, nigga.
Let's go.
Drop it low for me. Would you saddle up and hit the road for me? Get some dough for me. Stay up off blow for me. He don't know how to sweat. I'm a show homie. Hey, would you saddle up?
Let's go.
And hit the road for me. Get some dough for me.
Let's wait till we open up. We hit that second box already. We over 1K, but I don't really care for the 1K views. Let's get this shit up. Let's get this shit jumping. Y'all got a DIY notified? Do that for me. Let's go. Thank you, Nunu. Hold on, baby. We gotta wait for the the treasure box to open. We gotta wait for the treasure box to open. Hold on, Nunu. Thank you, baby. Cause the treasure box about to open right there to the right. I don't know, it might be out left. It's okay. Appreciate it. Still count. But it don't count for the treasure box, but thank you. Let's go.
Hey, bitch, shut the fuck up and cough it up. Stay down for me. Don't get this baby face fucked up. I'll pop you up.
Y'all don't gift me until the treasure box opens so we can fill it up.
It's a money game. It's just me and my feet. How I'm doing better than you, P. And you, D. Name ring bell through these streets because I'm a pro member. Baby, see my vision. She's a go-getter. You got friends. I collect bands for a living. Don't worry. You'll get the call if she ever come up missing. Your piece stand for porn star.
What's up,
I'm a big fish, you niggas, little cichlids. Yeah. Baby, sometimes I'm an asshole, but I'm a gentleman.
come straight to me. It ain't no middleman. Squares make me sicker. Bags make me sicker. I'm not your friend, bitch. I'm not your babysitter. Talk about money, well, bitch, when you talk to me. Why do you get scared when I talk about fees? Damn. Speaking on me, I ain't tripping, I'm getting richer. I'm a pro member, and we all some go-getters. Squares make me sick, and facts make me sicker.
Hold on, we gotta wait till it open, baby. It ain't open yet, Nunu. I'm a pro member. It ain't open, it's about to open right now. It's open right now, y'all, let's open.
Baby, let's have a drink and talk about this situation.
Let's fill it up.
I'm sick of waste.
Thank you.
You gon' lose. I'm just being honest.
Hold on.
But me behind you gon' see some commas. Broke niggas always talking. He ain't about a bag. You pay him and his brother. Bitch, use a bag.
Thank you,
shoot. Everything I got spelled
let's
like
go.
Believe that.
Let's go.
With the stars.
Thank you, Nunu. Thank you, shoot.
Passport on me.
We almost there.
Maybe I'll take a trip.
We almost there.
That's what the dolphins popping at.
Thank you so much,
Nunu.
Thank you so much, shoot. We have 77% back in trash.
I drive his feet.
Thank you,
crazy.
Thank you.
Oh, I got sick when I found out. She was the bag. Me and Squares don't get along. And
yeah,
that's
it. DIY notified. We fucked it up. We fucked it up. That's what I'm talking about. Good shit.
Make me sick. Facts make me sicker. Speaking on me, I ain't tripping.
We definitely about to hit this third. We about to hit this third box already. Let's go. All right, it's back open. It's the last time before the show starts. I'm about to switch it over right after this. This is the last time to fill it up right before the show starts. Let's go.
I'm a pro member.
Thank you, Nunu. Let's go. Appreciate it. Oh, you, hey, where? What's up, Shu? Can somebody throw a luxury car? What's up, Shells? Can somebody need two more luxury cars to fill it up? We got 50 seconds. How you looking, babe? What up, Shu? Hey, what's up with you, Helen? How old are you?
No, leave.
Because you cute, but I don't talk to underage women. Thank you. We got 28 seconds, y'all. Come on. We just need one more luxury car. Thank you, Shells. We got 20 seconds left. We need one more luxury car to fill it up. We almost there. We 60%. Thank you, Shu. Is it delayed? I think it's delayed. We got 5 seconds left. We ain't gonna do it. I don't think we're gonna do it. What up, Lexi? Thank you, Shu. Thank you, Lexi. We didn't do it. Thank you, Shells. What up, Barry Milk? Thank you, Lady Shu. What's up, Shu? What's going on? Thank you, Barry Milk. What's going on, Shu?
I'm checking to see how you are on Judges.
Okay, I'm about to show you in just a minute. And if not, I got late night, and I got you. I hit both of y'all up and told y'all. Well, I didn't hit up late night, but late night came in here and I let them know. And I told you the same thing, like, you know, backup if I don't have. Wait, hold on. Did I call you for a backup, or did I call you for a front judge? I'll be moving too much. What did I say in the text message? I gotta read.
Hold on, let me check.
Yeah, cause I gotta make sure. I'm
pretty
up.
Sure it's backup.
Yeah. Okay. Are you right?
Yeah, backup.
Okay, I just want to make sure, because you know I like to honor my word. I just want to make sure, you know what I'm saying, that I'm not saying nothing. What's up with you, baby? How you doing? Up there, Carly?
Hey, y'all, I want y'all to, Zari said it. Go cut the TV off in the living room.
Carly, oh, she didn't mean to be up here? You didn't mean to be up here, baby? Oh, it's okay. It's okay, baby. It's all right. We love you, Carly. We love you, baby. I don't think she knew that. What up, Berry Milk?
Yeah, I don't
know. You still lovely, baby. You still lovely. I'm gonna kiss you on your forehead with your bonnet on. You still lovely. Now shoot. So yeah, we about to switch over. We about to switch over. Hold on, what we at on the second? Because it's like we're about to hit this third real quick. What we at right now? Can you count for
me? I'll drop that.
Can you let me know where we at?
How do I check that? I'm gonna drop down so you can switch over. So just let me know if you. Very it sounds good. Like you're covered tonight.
You said what? We're about to start right now. You said we're about to start right now. So I know one of my judges told me they needed like 10 extra minutes. So that's Polygyny King. Oh, we just need one treasure? Somebody throw that one treasure real quick. We're about to switch over.
Okay. Well, I'll be, I'm around. It doesn't have to be this go around, but
already. Already. Thank you, Barry Milk. Y'all sure it was one treasure? Yeah. Okay, let's get started. I needed a second box and we got to a third, man. Fuck what y'all heard. I appreciate the love and we there. Thank you. Thank you, y'all. I appreciate all the love, man, from everybody. Thank you, Barbie No Cap. And let me go ahead and do this one more good time for the rhyme. Hopefully somebody got a DIY notify up in here so we can get that shit really, really, really cracking. All right, here you go. Hold on. All right.
Niggas, you just a nigga, better learn the difference. Better have your shoes laced, don't get caught up flipping. Cause Scooby shots a couple legs, knock you out your denim. Quick to cross, nigga, so you would think I'm Christy. Putting that shit on these gallery denim, boy, you can't talk to me. No salary. Got rich off of gallons and skittles. I put off on the floor, left a pal in the middle. Can't understand the lingo, got thousands of riddles. He caught a head, shot a couple rounds to the head. Niggas dying off the drugs, too much spinning on the hoes. What? Bougie just wasn't feeling y'all. Some biscuits in my studio, he gonna put them in a box. We the niggas in the city, we the niggas, you niggas not. I can't fuck with you, you have to be just with the cops. The biscuits just laying, I'm up and eating this with my Glock. The plug, we the niggas, you just a nigga, better learn the difference. Better have your shoes laced, don't get caught up flipping. Cause Scooby shots a couple of legs, knock you out your denim. Quick to toss, nigga, I'll see you and think I'm Christian. We them niggas, you just a nigga, better learn the difference. Better have your shoes laced, don't get caught up flipping. Cause Scooby shots a couple of legs. Quick to cross, nigga. I'll see you think I'm.
If it's a biscuit on your head, they hit your ass with hot peppers. He don't want to work it out the top stretch him. He knew that there's no holes in his socks. He's not.
All right, so this is what I plan to do. I plan to do an all men's panel today. Because I ain't never did that before on this. So today, yeah, you can. Yeah, hell yeah. Bring your ass up here. Hold on. Let me do the same thing. Oh, you said admin. I said audition. Yeah, I would have to take somebody's off. I would have to take a remove somebody's thing here. Give me a second. Yes, I was trying to have an all men. So right now, it's too much. Polygyny King. Visa can't make it. He hit me and told me he couldn't make it. So we're gonna have late night fill in for Visa. Hold on, Polygyny King, too much late night.
Yes, you know what it is. Where's my camera? That's my camera. All right. You clear? Yeah.
Oh, damn! I didn't hit Saturn. I didn't hit Saturn. I don't know if Saturn probably. I don't know. I didn't hit Saturn. No. But let's see. Yeah, we're going to try the all-man panel real quick.
We've always had a tentative panel.
Hold on. Yeah, it's last minute, so, you know. Hold on. And then I'm going to do an all-women panel. You said Saturn was good. Yeah, Saturn, you know, Saturn are legendary. Let me see something real quick. Damn, it seems like I'm missing somebody's name. It seems like I'm missing somebody's name. I want to make sure because I'm halfway. I ain't sleep, halfway sleep, but I'm still kind of like thinking. Now, all men panel, all men. Lisa said he was asleep, so he couldn't do it.
Let's go, let's do it. He got shit to do. He got a fight to catch me. Check the valves, Mr. Giles, you're winning still. These niggas think I'm allergic, past the advantage.
Damn, I got their number on this phone. I don't got their number on this phone. Hold on. Let me pull up everybody who all are here. All right, get us out of the queue. All my judges, get us out of the queue. Give me a second, y'all. Thank you, Nuno. And remember, we're still taking all new females and things of that nature. We're still taking new female entries and things like that. That's ready to build, man. Let's get over this 2K. Everybody share the live for me real quick. If you got a DIY notify, hit that DIY notify for me, all right? All right, Polygyny King here. Okay, go ahead and get in the queue, bro. And also, Too Much, get in the queue. Late Night, get in the queue. Hold on, let me see something real quick. Swiss, though, I'm still eating off the verses. I got more.
Let's go, let's go, yeah, let's go, yeah, it's gonna be interesting. We're getting this testosterone up in here, man. Yeah, man, let's get this testosterone going, then we're gonna do an all-female panel. Next, yeah, you know what's going on, what up, okay, I see you over there, put you in that big box, man, shining like a diamond, man, I see you over there, man, yeah, hey man, hey, I see you over there riding the spaceship, man, yeah, riding the spaceship, man, already, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's get it, let's get it, you know, hey, Too Much, the one.
What's going on, King?
Man, what's happening, brother? What's the business?
Man, not much. I can't call it, man. It's a blessing to live to see another day of being serving to God.
That's right. That's right.
Man, I know that's right, man. Yes, sir.
A millionaire, right?
Feeling good. Feeling good, man. Hey. It was real good seeing you with your wife today, man. Man, you looked happy, man. I loved it, bro.
Already, already, already. So look, Visa said, Visa said he's sleeping. Vanessa's on the road. So some of the men, I was gonna have, and Saturday ain't hit me back yet. So some of the men, I guess they're not available. Some of the men. Hey, Leah, you got to start hitting me back. You got to start hitting me back, Leah. When I be hitting you, you don't hit me back no more. You don't respond like. So I switched it to a whole man panel. But none of the men is, all the men ain't available anyway. But yeah. You don't be at.
But yeah, if the rest of the men don't show up.
No, they ain't. I mean, they ain't show. I mean, Vanessa can't do it and Visa can't do it. So, you know what I'm saying? So it's all good.
You want me to be the only girl?
I mean, we ain't got no choice unless I just, you know, shit. Feel me? You feel me?
I'm going to call you Bebe.
You said what?
I finished the camera with TKO.
Just kind of like TKO.
Wow, he said what? You hung up on him. Wow.
What y'all over there talk about? Who over there?
That's my man. I'm finna get it.
What you got?
Oh, my man could have did it. My man could have did it. Oh, that was
oh,
my
Philly
man.
Philly vibes over there. Philly vibes. Oh, you getting fucked right now.
Let me put no, you in the I'm big with my box. Mama. I no, fucked. I was on the phone with him.
She
went.
You
with
over
her
there
mama.
Getting. Oh, mother.
No, she not. She with her mama.
I'm gonna go to another room. You're so inappropriate, TKO.
Yeah, TKO, so inappropriate, right, Leah?
I'm sorry. Oh my god, Leah, why would you even set me up like that, Leah? Why would you?
I didn't know
me
you
up?
Were gonna say that.
I didn't. No, I'm not. Oh shoot, My bad.
What you mean? Hey, you know he ain't got no sense. Come on now.
Oh man, she set me up for the okie doke.
I got the conversation. My lady, she was blessed.
I feel bad. She said,
"Oh, to join his family, you could have at least sent a farewell message to the family."
Who's that? Okay. All right. So, all right. So, look, we're about to get started, y'all, and we're gonna start from the bottom to the top. So, Leah, go ahead and introduce yourself to the people. Look like Angela Bassett. Okay.
Hey, it's me, the Angela Bassett, aka the Lauryn Hill lookalike, aka the biggest snitch, aka the Karen, the bitch that all you bitches want off the app, the one with the flattest face and the flattest ass and the whitest fucking head. I don't give a fuck about none of you bitches, and I'ma stand on business, hoe, and I'ma keep snitching on your favorite host. Fuck y'all hoes.
Do your motherfucking thing. Next we got Late Night, man. He been in the motherfucking headlines a lot lately too, doing his motherfucking thing. Go ahead and represent.
Y'all know what type of time I'm on. I'm the biggest, I'm the baddest. Don't forget the realest. Real Ricky Money nigga. You know what I'm saying? And my bitch bad too. Got a fat ass and she walk like she know it. Yeah, you know, I'm here to do what we do. You know, turn up how we turn up. You know, I fuck with you, TK, y'all. Let your show. Let's get it bussing.
Already. Next we got my nigga Polygyny King picking up dust, one of the most intellectuals. I made that word up. But yeah, going on right now, man. Go ahead and represent yourself, man. Hey, y'all hit a DIY. If y'all got a DIY notify, hit that DIY notify right now. There's some three lines down there and tap DIY notify. Go ahead, bro.
No doubt. You already know Polygyny King. I'm one of the brothers that you love to hate. All praise to the Most High. Hey, I'm a spiritual real nigga. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm spiritual. Hey, but hey, I get down with this Bible. You know, that's what I stand on. You know what I'm saying? I'm still down to earth. I'm not religious, but I am a Bible thumper. You know what I'm saying? And I've been doing polygyny 21 years. I got 5 wives, and I'm courting a potential 6th wife now. I'm an author of 3 polygyny books. You can find it at propolybook.com. And look, hey, one of my deal breakers is if you ain't get down with this Bible, I ain't dealing with you. That's what it is.
That's on the gang, man. That's on the gang. Last but not least, my motherfucking brother from another mother. Go ahead, Too Much.
What up, man? Y'all know what it is. Too much to one, not to two, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, everybody got these nice spills or whatever. I'm going to keep it 100 with you, man. I'm just a working man out here. You hear me? So, you know, it is what it is. Y'all get with me.
Already, but that is a nice spill because a lot of niggas don't like to work or do shit or take care of their motherfucking family. So whatever the fuck you doing right now, that's the real spill, though. You know what I'm saying? That's the real spill for their motherfucking ass, though. You know what I'm talking about? And last but not least, man. Yeah, you can't fuck with the boy like a Catholic priest. It's that boy TK Capone, the almighty drip Messiah, the one that your girlfriend desired, but you gotta have what it required to join the motherfucking empire. You know what I'm talking about? And it's going down like that, man. And I wanna say I appreciate all my people that's up in here, you know what I'm saying, really giving it up and putting it down for us. You know what I'm talking about? And it's going down, you feel me? So who we gonna start out with today? You know, get inside the queue. If you wanna do the poly auditions and be a part of the poly auditions, to join the mission and diamonds glisten. You feel me? And we're gonna start out with, hold on. Thank you so much, my strawberry. That's a dude, right? Make sure y'all not in the, matter of fact, let me clear this queue real quick. There's some dudes up in here, man. Hold on. All right, get inside the queue. I need everybody to get inside the queue. It doesn't mean I'm gonna bring you up first. Dr. CC, you know you in the queue. Pink Perk, you know you in the queue. Thotty 2.0, you in the queue. La Destiny, Overdoses, Kaya, Kiki, and Hazel. All right, let's go. We starting out with Dr. CC. She in that queue. Don't kick Dr. CC, one of us. Dr. CC. If you already fall asleep, we ain't get started yet. Okay, I'm gonna drop her down. Okay. Let's start over again. Pink Perk. What up, Pink Perk?
What's poppin'? I didn't know I was supposed to be getting up here.
No, you was in the, baby, you was in the queue, Pink Perk.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna jump down.
Okay. All right. So, let me say this again. Let me say this again, y'all. Get out the queue if you're not here for the poly auditions. Get out the queue. I even mention y'all name. I'm not even talking fast. I even say y'all name. So y'all know y'all in the queue if I say y'all name. If we're watching the show and y'all in the queue, I'm saying y'all name before. Those was two names I just not called. I fuck with them, so I ain't going to do too much. I fuck with those two ladies, but y'all not listening. If you're in the queue, get out the queue. Get out the queue. I don't care if it's a new update, but because I said the names. So when I said the names, all they had to do is just get out the queue. All right. LaDestiny, she already on time. Let's go.
Hello?
What's up, baby? What's going on?
I can't hear you.
I can hear you, though. Oh, this is my Amish girl right here.
Hello.
What up, TKO Thinkums? Thank you, baby. You can't hear me still?
What's going on with mine? I can't hear nothing.
Can't hear shit. I'm not saying that until you can't hear me now.
Okay. I can hear you.
Yeah. You can hear me now? Okay.
Yes.
All right, baby. So you had came for the first time Saturday. Hold on, baby. Can you?
Yes.
What's up with the phone? Are you holding up with your hand or you got to sit on
something? I'm at work. It's just doing it. I'm finna walk into a different.
Did my comment?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So look, well, thank you for showing how dedicated you are for showing up while you at work. All right, baby. I appreciate that. What I need you to do for the people who missed you last week is go ahead and state where you from. If you got kids, how many kids you got, what's your situation? And just kind of go over a quick summary of the questions last week so we don't have to ask the same questions because we got some different judges, all right? So give us a brief summary about who you are, how old you are, where you from, and all that good shit. So if you want me to ask the question.
Okay. LaDestiny. I'm 48 years old. Out of Memphis, Tennessee. I have two kids. I had three. One was murdered, and now I have two living. They both are grown. And what else did you ask?
So you say you're 48? And
yeah, 48.
Three kids, one was murdered. You from Memphis, Tennessee?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
If it was something that you wanted us to understand about you as a person, who you are, what would that be?
Well, I am a aspiring movie writer. I've been at my job now for 18 years. I write plays, but I'm working on my first movie. It's called The Seven People in Her Head. I also wrote a play called If She Only Knew. I write about like taboo type relationships. And I'm interested in a poly relationship because I've been married before. And there is, like in my area, for instance, most of the good black men are already taken, or either they're in jail or they're lost in this world. So I feel that I would rather share my love with someone that's willing to have more than one woman than to just sit around and be lonely.
Right. Okay. You need to do also a book about the seven colors in your head. I think that'd be cute. Some little play off of it. You feel me? Doing your motherfucking thing. I like it. It's creative.
See, this, the blue,
Yeah.
The blue is for my son. He was murdered. And blue was his favorite color. He was also GD. And I just do the blue just to keep him with me at all times.
Okay.
I'm not. Right. My son was. And okay, it's just to keep him with me at all times.
That's so sweet. For sure, tea time. Okay. Can you show us how you looking today? I know you at work, but can we see?
I can. I don't mind.
Like? All right.
Yeah, let me sit this up.
You got that pumpkin edition. You got that. Oh, you got a nice little bus driver booty. Okay. All right, yeah, let's get it. Let's Let's get it. Let's get it. Okay. Okay. For sure. For sure. We're going to start out with my nigga Polygyny King on this one. Polygyny King. Go ahead and do your thing, brother.
Yes. Good evening. How you doing? Peace and blessings. How you doing?
I'm doing just one.
All praises. Okay. So, you said something that made me want to switch gears on questions, geared toward traumas. And the reason why I said this is because my fourth wife lost her son as well. So my first question is, how many questions we got?
Just go wherever. It's all good. We're okay. Just gonna flow.
Okay, cool. So my first question is, what makes you think that you would be ready to go into a relationship after dealing with the loss of your son? And the reason why I say this is because we know trauma is a very, very big thing in the Black community. But go ahead.
Well, I take each day as a new gift from God. And it was hard losing my dad. And then 6 months later, I lost my son. And him and his baby mother both were murdered at the same time. They had just had a 5-day-old baby. Oh, it was hard at first. Yeah, it was hard at first, but I just leaned and depended on God to help me through it. And I prayed daily, and I never stopped praying because I know if I put God first and allow him to direct my path, anything that the world throws at me, I already have my shield and sword ready.
I like that. You basically just gave me a little bit of Ephesians 6, 10 through 19. So I'm with that. I understand that. Okay, cool. So you also mentioned about the good man being taken. And I can relate to that as well. But you said something that made me want to ask you a question, because you said you were implying that you would want to do polygyny so that you wouldn't be lonely. What would you say to people who might ask, well, are you doing this just to be settling? You know what I'm saying? Like, are you sure this is what you want to do? Or are you like afraid to be alone?
I mean, if I was settling, I could get, build my own tribe, because there is a lot of guys that need some type of guidance. And I'm a very powerful woman. And then if I was going to settle, I could just move people in who need somewhere to stay or that don't have their own. But that's not what I want. I want to be able to build. I want someone to respect me, and I could also respect. I want someone that's not afraid of a woman that has her own vision, because my previous relationship, my husband had a problem with me making more money than he did. And I was like, we're building this together. And he felt that there was a problem to have a woman with her own mind.
All right. I'm glad you mentioned these things. So, there are things that I am definitely keying in on. Powerful woman saying, like, hey, if I was settling, then there are guys that may need X, Y, and Z. You had issues with your previous marriage. So I can definitely tell that you are a Bible believer, correct? So the Bible says, that the wife is supposed to submit to her husband as unto the Lord. And remember, according to the Bible, the woman is made for the man, not the man made for the woman. So you being a Bible believer, being the helpmeet, your job is to come into his house and to help fulfill his vision, not your vision. So biblically speaking, how would you be able to deal with something like that, knowing that, TKO is building his empire the way he sees fit? Is that going to conflict your vision versus his vision?
No, I don't feel that it will. I don't feel that it will make me second to his, because I feel that a man is the head of a household. And I feel that I could work on mine and still help build what he's trying to do. And if he felt that I needed to back it down a little bit, I don't have a problem with that.
Okay, my last question is, what if he say he wants you to just back off that, just hit the brakes on it totally, and you do what I need you to do?
I'll pray about it first because I feel that God is not going to lead me somewhere that I shouldn't be. And if I pray about it and the Spirit tells me, hey, maybe this is not a fit, then I'll be able to go to my man and say, hey, there's a power that's higher than you. And he tells me that maybe this is not going to work. I feel communication is the key to anything that's going to be successful or anything that will fail.
So it sounds like there'll be a deal breaker.
I mean, not necessarily, but I would pray about it first.
The Bible says in Ephesians 5:24, therefore is the church is subject unto Christ. So let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. So the Bible says you ought to obey your husband in everything. So when I asked you that question, when you said you was about to go pray, the Bible tells you to obey. You get what I'm saying? So if you a Bible believer, the book say you gonna submit to him just as you would the Lord. So I know that was an issue in your last marriage. From what it sounds like, that this would be a deal breaker for you. So you telling me you wouldn't obey?
That's not what I meant about not obeying. I was saying that if he told me that, and then I thought that I should still be able to pray daily, and then I will be able to talk to him to see why it is that he don't want me. If he thought that my dreams was interfering with his, then we could talk about it. I mean, I don't know if it will be a fit or not without communication.
What if he say he don't owe you no explanation? Polygyny King told you that the Bible say do what I say. So I don't owe you no explanation. You do as you told. Where we at now?
If we made it that far where he's chosen me to be a part of his empire and he said, hey, this is what I want you to do, then that's what I would submit to do. I thought we was referring to before you're chosen.
No, I'm talking about you becoming his wife. But that's what I wanted to know. I don't want to linger it on, but yes, you know.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Already. Next we got, thank you for that, bro. Next we got Leah. Leah, go ahead and do your thing, Leah.
Hello, beautiful.
Hey, girl, I was going to give you a hard time, but you just too nice. I can't even do it. I was going to come up here and just be hard on your ass and just put you up against the ropes and that. You know, but nah, you're just too sweet. I can't do you like that. But let me piggyback off the question about marriage. Are you, if that's something that you're looking to do, or are you just ready to just be a sister wife? You don't need no paperwork or nothing. You just ready to come in and just love.
Well, I feel that marriage is ordained through God. And every relationship will not lead to marriage. So I'm not coming in with any preconceived ideals. I'm just willing to accept where I am needed.
Okay. And also, I remember you said that your ex-husband complained about you making too much. Tiki, y'all would never complain about you making too much. Quite frankly, he would never do that. Never. He welcomes all the get money bitches. But let me think if I have any more questions for you while you're up here. Okay, so as far as your age, do you feel like your age will be a benefit? Because I know you're a little bit older than the women that he typically dates. Do you feel like your age will probably be a benefit or, you know, a hindrance in this relationship?
I don't feel that it will be a hindrance because everybody is an individual. I have years on me, but I feel you're only as old as you feel. There is wisdom that came with my age. There's things that I had to go through. And the things I went through, I'm able to help other ladies around me to keep them from going through some of the good and bad decisions that I made throughout the life. So I feel that it will be a contribution to the group.
Definitely. I will say this. I do like you, though. You seem really nice. That's all I wanted to ask.
Thank you.
Alrighty. Thank you so much, Leah. All right, before we get started with the next, can somebody please drop us a beautiful DIY notify real quick. Next, we going to late night. Late night, go ahead and do your thing. Can we get a DIY notify real quick, y'all? Hit them three lines down there. We haven't got one tonight. Get a DIY notify for us. Go ahead, late night.
Okay. So, is she there or is she lagging? She's frozen right now.
She's frozen.
Working the truck stop, so I can hear you. I don't know if you can hear me.
All right, yeah, we can hear you. Go ahead, do your thing.
Okay.
So, yeah, I can't see you, but I can hear you.
Okay. That's fine. That's fine. So, have you ever had a threesome?
Yes.
Do you eat ass?
No.
Would you be willing to eat ass?
Haven't really thought about it. This is like the third time I've been
asked. Okay, well, TKO tells you to eat his TKO tells you to eat his ass. Is you gonna eat his ass?
I'm kind of hesitant to answer that.
I need a yes or no.
You heard what Polizzi said, though.
I need a hold on, hold on, hold on. No, TKO, please, okay. It's my time. Okay. Don't assist her. No one assist her. I need a yes or no, ma'am. I need a yes or no, ma'am. All
right. If he asks me, even though he knows that I know nothing about it, then I'm willing to try.
So is that a yes or no, ma'am?
Yes.
Okay. Have you ever been in a poly relationship before?
No.
So it's fair to say that this is an experiment to you.
I feel that it's a new adventure. I won't call it an experiment.
Like an experiment. Okay. You don't think that he's just a little too I'm not saying that you're old or too old, but I'm just saying you don't think he's a little too high speed for your speed? Are you out there turning up and going crazy like TKO?
No, I'm not turning up, but I don't think everybody that he want them doing the same thing.
Okay, that's fair. That's a good answer.
He needs to be there to raise the baby.
Oh.
That's a good answer. They're finna have a baby.
Oh, you want to be the nanny? Okay. TK. No, I heard. It's okay. It's a good answer. No further questions.
Okay. Appreciate you late night. Last but not least, we got too much. What you think about this this nice bobcat? I wasn't gonna call her a cougar, but she cuter.
Yeah. I think she a sweet lady, man. How you doing tonight, ma'am?
I'm doing just wonderful, and you?
Okay, my first question for you, and I want you to give me an honest answer, and also think about this, if this is a possibility. Was it him being insecure that you make more money, or did you start to treat him different because you were the breadwinner?
Ooh.
Well, I was never, it wasn't that I was the breadwinner, because I just made more money, but I always made sure that he knew that he was the king of my household. I would do it even like, well, let's say as if we went out to eat, I would transfer money to his account before we went, so wouldn't nobody see me paying for food. In the public eyes, I always wanted him to be upfront, and I was always his support person. He lost his job. He wanted to become a rapper, couldn't even rap. And so I made sure all the bills were paid.
Let Leah say what she's gonna say real quick. Go ahead.
Look, I'm not gonna be with no broke nigga, but the way I see it, he still felt the way about you making more, even though you was giving him all of these leeways, giving him money for y'all. But yes. I wish I would help a broke nigga not feel broke. Fuck out of here with your broke ass. You did all of that shit for that broke nigga, he still wasn't thankful. Fuck these broke niggas. Fuck all the broke. If you a broke nigga in this life, fuck your ass.
I got something to say to that too, though. You know.
thank you, Leah.
She didn't say he was broke. She said he had less money than her. But the thing I would say to that is, you know, was it? How did you go about doing that, though? You know what I mean?
When I met him,
let me slow down for just a second. Hold on. I'm asking that because it is a way that you can be belittling when you do it. You know what I'm saying? There's a way that you can be being kind when you do it. You know what I'm saying? So I'm asking these questions to find out.
Yes. I was giving an example. Like when I met him, he was up. He fell down. And when he fell down, I did not allow the society to know that my man was down. I worked extra hard our household stayed. Yes.
Hold on, baby. Do you feel like you add or do you subtract in a relationship?
I'm always going to try my best to add to.
No, I didn't say try your best. Do you add or do you subtract?
I add.
So if you add and he was up when you met him, but then he fell off when he was with you.
No, he fell off because he was running from the police and I didn't know about it.
I didn't. He fell off.
That's how he that's what I'm saying. That's how he fell off. Okay, because so he went to jail.
Dude, what type of dude was he?
When I first met him, he was a really caring. It was like a wolf that was in sheep's clothing. I didn't see that at first.
Running from the police, what type of dude was he? What was he running from? What did he do?
He said he had like some old charges in Chicago, and that's why he moved to Memphis. He didn't tell me what it was about.
So to this day, you don't know what he was running from the police for?
No, I don't. Because when he, once he got out, we had a whole nother life. He wanted to leave the past in the past. I thought everything was fine. Things were going good. He came home one day and said, hey, I got a baby. And I was like, what do you mean you got a baby? And he said, I didn't want you to find out about it from somebody else, but a girl that works for me just had my baby yesterday, and I'm finna move in with her.
So what attracted you to him in the first place?
You said what?
What attracted you to him in the first place? What pulled your attention to this man?
I do a lot of community work, and he was one of the volunteers at one of, I did a lupus benefit concert, yeah. I did a lupus benefit concert to raise awareness to people who are suffering from lupus in this area, and he was one of the volunteers, and he was just constantly giving me this amazing attention, and he was always there wanting to help. And then my dad, I was taking care of my dad, just started before my dad died.
That's fine, no, that's fine. So he was giving you attention.
Yeah.
What is his age today? Today, what's his age?
33.
What year was he with him?
26 when I got with him. Huh?
He was 26. And yes. What was you like? 40? 39? 40?
40. I just turned 38 last month.
30? Hold on. 38 or 48?
I just turned 48 March the 17th.
Okay, so you saw this young guy, and he was giving you a lot of attention. And
yes. You
just said, fuck it. Let me go ahead and just dedicate myself to this dude.
Well, we started dating, and he was just, he seemed, at the beginning, just seemed so into me and so into the things that I was doing. And the sex was good.
That's what, okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay. All right, that rest my case. Go ahead.
Oh, no. Well, what I was finna get to with all of that was, I heard you earlier say, you know, there are men who need things and, you know, you could provide and make things happen for them. So to me, man, it looks like you may have the traits of an enabler. You know what I'm saying? So, like, you know, I ain't saying you're a bad woman for that. Yeah, you know, I don't think you're a bad woman for that. But, you know, I was just trying to get that out there real quick. My last question is this, though. Besides, you know, writing movies and books and, you know, your creative side, and I'm not against that, by the way, I'm creative myself, but, you know, besides your creative side, what plans do you have for your life and what are you doing to make them happen?
Well, as far as my plans for my life, right now, I just want to be happy. I've took a whole lot of losses the last few years. And for so long, I was a people pleaser. I was doing everything I could to make sure everybody else was okay and really wasn't concerned about what I want.
I understand, but that didn't answer the question at all. Okay, go ahead.
I mean, you asked me what was my plan. So that's what I was thinking to say. That
you said you want to be happy. But even with that, yes. Let me just add it. When you say you want to be happy, what do you think is going to bring you happiness? I think that's very important. What is that? Like, what's going to bring you happiness? What up, Cole Money?
Being appreciated, being able to feel love. I've always given love, but not too often have I felt it.
So look, I'm gonna tell you something and you might not respect it, but it's the truth. You're not ready for a relationship yet. I'm gonna tell you why. Because you feel insignificant without another human being loving you, making you feel love. I want to feel love. Once you realize that you are love, you're a part of God, and you love your motherfucking self, you don't have to be codependent on nobody else. So right now, you're trying to unleash yourself to somebody else so you can just feel love and feel significant in this world without even knowing, having knowledge of yourself, knowing you already are significant. So when I'm fucking with somebody, I want them to know I can stand and feel love and feel powerful whether I'm with you or without you. I love a woman to have self dignity about herself. They can feel love. And so when we come together, we just two people feeling love already. And we just happened just to meet. And we met in the middle. But not somebody just coming to me, because you got to understand, the same person who's going to make you feel love going to make you feel pain too. If you become a reliant, you don't have to feel love from nobody. You have to be love. Just be love yourself. Know who God is. Feel significant with you. You should be feeling love right now. If you was by yourself, I like somebody who can stand on their own and be complete on their own. You don't need a man to complete you. They probably told you this, or they probably made you feel like this, but that's not true. You don't need nobody to complete you to make you feel that love, that void that you're looking for. All you need is God and yourself. And it's good to be like that first, so you won't be hoodwinked or get with the wrong people, with the wrong patterns that finesse you by the things that they say to you to make you feel love, to give you this false hope, because you don't really know what love is. Go ahead, too much.
I respect that to the fullest.
Yeah, that pretty much sum it up, though. You know, when it comes to self-love, man, that's self-respect. You know what I mean? So if you ain't ready to, you know, dive into the self-respect, you're not ready for a relationship, because you'll find yourself putting yourself in positions where you use you allow people to use you, and you use yourself. You misuse yourself. And that's all I got to say.
Okay, so right now I'm about to unmute everybody for any last words. Did y'all want to say any last words to the sweet woman? Go ahead.
Yeah, I wanted to ask a few more questions. What exactly do you like about TKO the most?
His honesty.
What about his wives? How do you see yourself cohabiting with them? What do you like about them as well?
I haven't seen any of them. I'm new to this site. I've seen, today was the first day that I actually saw the, today was the first day. I'm not really big on the social media. I had saw him on TikTok one day when I was just scrolling through, and it drew my attention. And then I was told to,
hold on.
He broke his arm, Dave.
Right there.
Broke his arm.
Ooh, give me a talk. Give me a talk.
He's dying. Give me a cup. I found him. Oh, you killed him.
I didn't kill him. I never even touched him. I never even touched him.
He committed a murder. To kill a mockingbird, y'all.
Okay, y'all seen in real life. I need a paper, babe. I need a paper. Paper.
This is an exclusive. All right, y'all.
It's a fucking vampire.
Oh, my bad. All right. Now finish your thought. You was almost finished with it, but go ahead and finish your thought. You still there, LaDestiny, baby?
I am.
Go ahead and finish your thought. I heard most.
What do you like about TKO's wives, and how can you see yourself fitting in dynamic with them?
I haven't met any of them. I've only seen him on live with one lady. Most of the time I've been at work, and I've only been following him now. It's almost 3 weeks, but I can't sit up on social media, so I don't know a lot about him yet.
Hold on, you got to listen to my questions. I didn't ask if you met him, and then I'm asking, what do you like about his wives, and how can you see yourself fitting in the dynamics with them?
Okay, that's what I was saying. I don't know. I've never seen any of them. I haven't met any of them, so I can't say what I like or dislike about them.
All right. I rest my case. All right.
All right, cool. Anybody else? Everybody cool? Anybody got any questions? Nope. Everybody got no questions. All right. All right. Well, thank you, LaDestiny. I think you did good. And I think that it froze in a cool little picture. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to see you this Thursday, okay?
Okay. All right. I'm going to say off work Thursday so they work.
That works. I'm glad it does, baby. Much love to you, all right? All right. Okay, cool. That's cool. Little first. All right. Overdoses. We got overdoses. I'm going in a row. All right. Next, we got Hazel. Let's go. What it do? How you doing, beautiful?
Hi. Good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. How you feeling tonight?
I'm good. A little good? Nervous.
A little nervous. Have you sipped tonight? Are you sipping?
I got my wine a little bit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How did I know? Okay, tea time. So look, check this out. Yeah, I can see it in your eyes a little bit and feel it in your spirit. Can you give them a quick little rundown about how old you are, if you got kids, where you live at, if you did poly before, and whatever else you would like to tell us? Go ahead.
Okay, I'm Hazel. I'm 32. I live in Miami. I'm a bartender and a makeup artist. I don't have any kids.
Have you did poly before? And if you did poly before, why didn't it work?
Because he cheated in a poly relationship.
And you flew to Vegas and he was off of Bigo?
Mm-hmm.
Tea time. All right, we're gonna start out. I'm gonna swipe the comments. Okay, we're gonna start out with late night on this one. Late night, go ahead and do your thing.
How you doing, Hazel? Give me a favor. Who is well respected? 83.
Who is who?
His name is well respected 83.
That's my homeboy Ty.
Okay. When you say homeboy, is there any type of flirtatious activities or anything more? Does he flirt with
there
you? You would fair to say this is like a guy that's kind of trying to talk to you or something?
At the moment, no. In the past, when he was on Beagle, yeah.
Oh, in the past when he was on Bigo?
Mm-hmm.
He's not on Bigo no more, but you still have his picture posted on your page. You have a picture with him. You have a picture with him on your page.
I haven't been a host for so long. That's irrelevant.
Oh. Okay, I was just trying to see if there was any relevance to the picture and the guy.
That's my homeboy. Okay, so
he's your homeboy. He's your homeboy now. He's your homeboy now, right? Because y'all were talking, right?
We weren't talking. We never talked. We never had relations, anything. He was my friend. There was flirtatious activities. Well, yeah, he did flirt. Can I talk? Are you going to let me talk?
Okay.
Okay. So, yeah, we did flirt, but I encouraged him to do his music, and I was rocking Block Rich yesterday, also on, I think, if it wasn't on the Poly audition. I support him. So I pushed him to do music, and he's doing it now. But that picture is old.
Okay. You asked?
How do you know his name is well respected? You looked at the picture?
We're on Bigo. Do you eat ass?
I've done it in the past, yes.
Okay. No further questions, Your Honor.
Okay. Good question. Thank you so much, late night. Next, we're going to jump to Too Much. Too Much, go ahead.
Okay, what's going on? My first question is, how would you react to your man telling you, shut the fuck up, I don't care what you got to say, just do what I said?
I'm a very submissive woman, so I would probably do it if I'm keeping it real.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna ask you a question I just asked the other lady. So what are your plans for your life and what are you doing to make them happen?
Well, I bartend. I make a lot of money bartending. My dream job will be to open a makeup studio. So I'm good at that.
And what are you doing to make it happen?
I do weddings. I do it part-time, but I make more money. It's more, my income is more stable in the bartending industry, so.
Right. Okay. And when it comes to finances with your spouse, with who you working with, how do you do with that? You know what I mean? Do you share or are you a my money is my money type of person?
No, I share.
Okay. I ain't got
no
more questions.
In all my relationships, I've been the breadwinner. So yeah, I do share.
Okay, I'm keeping that light on her. All right, go ahead, Leah.
So speaking of you being the breadwinner and loving to share, how would you feel about paying bills in TKO's mansion?
Well, I've been in an 8-year relationship and I've paid all the bills, so.
So you fine like this, you good like this, and you paying all the bills?
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with you? Oh, my bad.
What's wrong with me?
Nothing. No, I didn't mean to say that. That slipped out. Fuck that. Ain't nothing wrong with you, girl.
Which I understand where you're coming from. But I felt like at that time I was in a relationship with someone that was a narcissist. So, like, he would say he's investing money and he's selling this and doing that. But he would be out all night and there was no income. So that was my fault.
He was finessing you.
Yeah.
So if you were to get into another situation like that, would you want the nigga to show you where the money going and shit like that?
Show me where the money's going?
Yeah, like if you was to give him money and he's like, babe, I'm finna make an investment. Da-da-da-da. Would you want to actually see the paperwork or see where the investments are going? Like, because you've been
Absolutely.
Burned before.
Absolutely.
Okay. You mentioned that you don't have kids. How do you feel about coming into a situation where he's about to have a brand new baby?
I love kids. It's not an issue with me.
So you're not going to be
pinched. But I also want kids of my own. So if I'm walking into this, I would also want a baby.
How long into this would you probably think you would want one?
Well, I only probably have 3 years before it's harvest, so.
3 years, so about 3 years you want to get impregnated.
Mm-hmm.
And about that time period, okay. You seem really calm. Have you ever had any domestic violence issues?
Domestic violence as far as me?
Yeah, like you ever hit a nigga in his shit or bust out some windows?
No, I've had it against me. I have. But
you
I
be
don't
fucking your friends on people. Are you a hoe? You be fucking behind your friends?
Absolutely not.
So at the strip club, do you be getting hit on a lot?
I don't work at a strip club.
The bar?
I do get hit on a lot.
You couldn't find no man in there?
Could have.
Okay. Just checking.
Probably this time.
That's all my line of questioning.
Alrighty. Hey, I'm seeing a lot of shade in the comments, and I'm seeing how my admins are not kicking that shade out for disrespecting Armani and things of that nature. I don't respect that. So if I gotta switch this shit around, we're gonna switch this shit around because y'all starting people getting lazy. I don't know what the fuck is going on, but y'all letting a lot of disrespect go on. Hazel. So when she said that you couldn't find another man, and you just say, yeah. So you're just looking for a man? And you're not looking for the man that you feel like is qualified to lead you in this lifetime? Because you should have corrected her on that.
Well, I'm not looking for no man. Okay. I've come out of a abusive relationship for 8 years.
When she asked you that you couldn't just find another man instead of
I can find another man.
What I'm saying to you, I think you're missing what I'm saying to you, because anybody can find another man. I can find any bitch.
Right.
So I don't want any bitch. Listen, I'm talking. I don't want any bitch. I want the woman that's gonna be in alignment and equally yoked with my life. So if you feel like I'm equally yoked with you, then that should have been your response. Like, yeah, of course I can find any man, but I want what's in alignment.
Man, I want
so do you else. Do you think I'm just another nigga?
No, if I did, I wouldn't be up here.
So that's why I'm going off that response. You get what I'm saying? She asked you that, and instead of say, yeah, I can find another man, like, because we know it's men everywhere. We know it's men all around Miami, all across the motherfucking United States. So the way you responded is just like, well, you know, yeah, he's in that same category of just men. So I just want to ask you that.
Well, if it came across like that, I apologize. No, that's not what I meant.
All right. Last but not least, my boy Polizzi King, go ahead.
What is a normal pH balance for a woman?
What is a what?
A normal pH balance for a woman.
I don't know.
Okay. What does submission mean to you? Because you said the question was asked, were you submissive? What does that mean?
What does submission mean to me?
Yeah, what's
exactly? To submit to a man that I could trust to lead me in the right direction. Not a man that don't have nothing going for himself.
No. I didn't ask you who you would submit to. I'm asking, what does it mean?
Submission?
Yes.
To submit to a man.
What does it mean? You're just saying the word. What does submit mean?
To follow his lead. To trust him.
No. It's not what submission means. All right, so what is your weakness?
My weakness would be thinking everybody has a good heart, maybe.
Explain.
Like, everyone is as nice as me, and that's not what it is.
What if he said he didn't want to give you his children? That's not what he wants for you. What then?
Then that wouldn't align with what I want for me. So then that would work. And I wouldn't be able to commit to that.
That's a good answer. Actually, that's a good answer. I respect that. That's a good answer. Because it's about being equally yoked.
Which is why I asked about submission. So what are your strengths?
As far as
when it comes to being in a polydynamic, because you said you were in a polydynamic before. So if you were to come into a polydynamic, what would be your strengths? I know you said that you were a breadwinner in the previous times.
Well, I'm a natural nurturer. Okay, I cook, I clean, I do my part. I work, I make money. I support my man.
What's TKO's favorite meal to eat?
I said that yesterday. Salmon and Alfredo. He likes bean stock too.
Wait, you said what now?
Olive Garden, salmon, Alfredo.
What?
Parmesan. I think from Wingstop.
What would you say would be a deal breaker for you to me? Like, you know what? Can't do it. What's a deal breaker for you?
A deal breaker would be that I want a son or whatever God gives me. And if he can't give me that, then that'd be a deal breaker for me.
Okay. What about when it comes to his wives? What would be a deal breaker with them that'll make you say, you know what? I got to go. I can't do this.
Good question.
I think I get along with everybody. So, okay, I'm getting there. A deal breaker for me would be I don't know.
Why did the last poly dynamic that you were in didn't work?
I said it already.
The reason why I'm asking, why?
Because he felt like he needed to go out and cheat when he could have just brought her to us.
What type of dynamic was it? Was it a closed poly dynamic, open poly? What type of poly dynamic were you in?
It was an open, it was two girls and him. It was an open dynamic, which means like we were open to other females. But if you didn't feel the need, his excuse was like, oh, I was going to see first if she was fit for a dynamic. But if you're going behind her back to do so.
Okay, so sweetheart, that's a close. Go ahead.
Yes, let me break it down. I know where bro about to go. I'm going to let him break it down even better than what I'm about to break it down to you. So it's different type of polygynies. I practice polygyny, but I practice closed polygyny. He practiced closed polygyny. If it was open polygyny, that means he can go fuck on anybody he wants to anytime he want to go fuck on.
So
polygyny king, he does open polygyny. I do closed polygyny. So it seems like he was doing open polygyny and you wanted it to be closed polygyny. But go ahead, polygyny king, did I say anything wrong?
No, you didn't. That's why I was getting at. So when an open polygynous dynamic consists of, there's no such thing as cheating or whatnot. So that's what ultimately I was getting at. So hypothetically speaking, even though my brother does close polygyny, what happens if he were to do that? Be gone or what? Like, how does that work?
No. Once you have an understanding with somebody.
She went in a blinds.
Is that him calling you right now?
Mm-hmm. Also, while she in the blinds, and you give me admin, I seen some of them comments. I kick them the fuck out too, cause I saw that.
Let me see who up in here, man. Cause I got over 20. I should be good if they. Okay, we got Shortcake, Carefree Shells, Lisa the Other Tambra, Lexi Bay, Clam God, Lotus. Damn, we got a lot. AKA Bay and Honey. It's Angie. Yeah, we got them there. We got a lot.
Bad. Okay. Cool.
So, no, I was crying a phone, bitch.
They're kicking them out. They're getting them together.
Good. Okay, so.
No. It was in an open thing. It was closed, meaning like we would have to agree. We agreed as a whole. Like if you were going to bring somebody else in, you would introduce us and we would all have to agree whether or not we would want to be in there. So it was a closed.
Okay. Last question. Let's say hypothetically speaking, if you felt like you were being treated last in your dynamic, how would you handle that?
I'm very not jealous.
The alcohol is just gonna stop.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay, we're gonna go to late night, and thank you for that polygyny. We're gonna go to late night. Late night had a word to say. Go ahead, bro.
One, it's not really a question. I don't really get submissive vibes from you. I get a lot of argumentative vibes. I get a lot of highly opinionated vibes. I don't think you maybe know the word submissive correctly. Even you went, I get it, maybe arguing with someone you're not talking to, like us, the judges, but you was going, you argued with TKO for a little bit, and y'all had a little back and forth moment for that. At least by my record, lasted about 15.7 seconds, a little back and forth. You were talking about agreements. And if you have an understanding, and the understanding that you gave us was you were submissive, and I didn't get that. Can you put her in a big box? Can we get a 360? Can I see what she looks like? Like, I don't know what I'm really talking to. Can we get a
body? We already did that. I'm squared.
Like, I wasn't here. I wasn't here though.
And I'm not doing it again.
She gets very submissive vibes.
Why she got a? You mean to her? You would just
no
mean
one.
Her.
No, listen, Leah. Just because no one asks you for to stand up ever in your life,
I don't give a fuck. An opinion.
No one's talking to you. No one has an opinion on you. No one has an opinion on you. Okay, no one has an opinion. No one has an opinion. No one cares about what you're standing up and look like. No one cares about whether you stand up or not to show that flat ass. Okay, no one gives a hell about that. No one gives a hell about that. Your face is flat and your ass is flat and your titties is long. Shut your ass up. I don't give a fuck about what you're talking about. You just lied to everybody, said you don't support broke niggas. That's a breaker, bro. Nothing about you makes sense. I don't give a fuck what you're talking about. Stop talking to me. Order.
We're gonna recalibrate. Get some order. We're gonna recalibrate. We're gonna recalibrate, y'all. We're gonna recalibrate. All right, Hazel. Do anybody got any last questions for Hazel?
Hazel, I just wanted to ask you this. I really appreciate the way that you stood firm in that. I could tell you are a very submissive woman, and I'm glad that you did not let that sack of shit talk crazy to you and then stand up and let him see that fat ass, because I know you got a fat ass. I could tell by them lips.
No, it's not. It's little.
Hold on. Let me just tell her. She's a beautiful woman, but in the ass department is yet a point too negative.
Can you not compare me to nobody?
It's okay. I will. All right, go ahead.
Okay, well, yeah, I can tell by them lips. You got them nice fat lips. I thought you had a fat ass too. But everything about you was fine as hell. So I hate that he just tried to disrespect you and ask you to see your body like that. I hate that type of shit.
Damn, he's a nobody.
But yeah, I like you. You're nice.
For sure.
I like you too.
And one thing I want to say that I like about about you is that you respectfully asked me not to do it. You didn't say, don't, you didn't yap at me, so I could. You get a point for asking me respectfully not to compare you to nobody. I can also point out things I don't like, but I could point out things I do like too.
Well, can you point out things that you don't like about me? Because I do like constructive criticism. I could take that.
You want that right now?
Yeah.
Shall be the political coupon. I'll keep it light. Cause I don't really look about what I don't like in people. I really kind of try to look what I do like, unless it's just jumping out at me. And one thing I do see from you is you seem like it's kind of tricky, because it's not very combative, but for it to be so early, it seems like you're kind of like a combative. You got like a combative nature about yourself, and I can tell that's not used to. See, like right now, you see how I'm talking, and I didn't finish what I was saying. You kind of cut me off. That's my pet peeve. I'm really big. I hate that, and everybody know I hate that. So things like that, things like that, those can be adjusted but you got to be aware of that and want to adjust that for me. You get what I'm saying? Because it can be adjusted. I think you got the comprehensions, you know, the capacity in your mind to be able to, you know, do things like that and evolve. However, you got to want to do that, because I've already told you that, I think twice already. And I see that you haven't corrected that part about that. So that'd be probably like the only thing right now. And when it comes down to the body, I'm not one of those shallow people, because I know we can fix that. I can get you in that gym, you know, I can get you doing some squats, and I also can, you know, bust a load in your ass every night and they can pump it up. So I'm not really tripping on the ass department. That's about it. You know, I don't really know too many other things. If anybody else, I think too much. Or anybody else wanna add?
Oh, no, I was just gonna ask. No, go ahead, bro.
Nah, the Yetta 2.0 negative did it for me. I have no further questions, Your Honor.
Okay, too much?
Yeah, I heard you earlier saying, you know, you wouldn't pick just no any old other nigga again. And I'm like, what makes him not any old other nigga in your eyes? And how well do you know him?
Well, I don't really know him physically, but for what I see, I think he would be a good leader for me. He knows how to lead.
Do you know how to follow, though? I know how to lead, but do you know how to follow?
Yeah, I know how to follow the right man.
I'm glad we're having this conversation. I hate when people reply like that. That's the worst thing you could have said to me. If you know how to follow, you know how to follow regardless. And you can choose who you want to follow. Don't get me wrong. So it's not about following. Like, do you know how to follow or do you not know how to follow? That's like me saying, do I know how to lead or do not? Well, I know how to lead the right women. Like, no, I know how to lead. It's my choice if I want to involve you in my life to lead you. So do you know how to follow or you don't?
Yeah, but what I'm saying is I followed for so long and I followed the wrong men.
That's not what I'm asking you. I'm not asking if you followed the wrong men. I'm asking you, do you...
So I, what I'm saying is I trust you to lead, and I will follow you. That's what I'm saying.
Too much in polygyny. Do y'all want to elaborate on any of this?
No.
Nope. Y'all good? Okay.
Yep.
I mean, yeah, that is what it is. You know, you already heard, man. It's all good. I ain't got nothing to say.
Now, what do I hear too much? I don't know, brother. What do I hear?
What you just heard her say. You know, excuse me for interpreting your words, but, you know, this is what it sounds like. It sounds like he asked you, do you know how to follow? And you did the same thing again when he was talking about the combative nature. That's one thing. The other thing is, we just had this conversation the other day on the panel. You know what I'm saying? As far as, you know, whether you know how to follow or not or be submissive, it has nothing to do with, you know, who you dealing with. Now, we not saying that you just supposed to follow some dumbass nigga over a bridge, but that's not the conversation at hand. And it sounds like you've been through so many traumatic experiences that you would bring traumatic baggage into the relationship because you have to voice that. You know what I'm saying? If you healed from that, that's not really a thing that you have to voice.
Right. So basically what he's saying is to follow up on that. If I'm asking you, do you know how to follow? The last thing you should be telling me is the right man because you was following the wrong man. Because I'm not asking you anything about the wrong man. I'm not asking you about your past. I'm living in the present moment with you. I want to build with you. I don't care about the losers that came in your life that didn't handle their business. They ain't got nothing to do with me. Just like there's been a lot of sorry ass, mark ass, faggot ass bitches that been in my life. They don't got nothing to do with you though. You get what I'm saying?
I agree. But already. Yeah, with I know how to follow.
Okay. All right. So all right. Well, you did very well. We appreciate you.
And, I'm not sure I did very well, but
you said what?
I said, I'm not sure if I did very well.
Do you have any insecurity issues, and what would they be if you do?
I do have insecurities.
And what would they be?
I don't know. I'm just insecure sometimes.
Huh? Okay, a lot of people have insecurities. Some people have insecurity where it's
like, maybe my body. My body, so
even with that, I see you as a beautiful woman, right? And we can, like I said, we can help that. But what would you want to do to change that insecurity issue? Because you know you got 24 hours in a day, and only you can change your own predicament. And you say you make a lot of money, you do a lot of things. Like, what are you doing about that since you're insecure about it? What's the solution for that?
Probably hitting the gym.
All right. So, and it's not probably, yeah, of course, hitting the gym will work. So why aren't you having the structure to do it? The discipline.
I will.
That didn't really happen. Okay. All right, that's cool. That's cool.
I got one more thing to say, man. Okay.
Go ahead, too much.
Yeah, I think it really comes down to wanting to be perfect. You know what I'm saying? Hold on, I'm echoing. Yeah, but it's like wanting to be perfect, man. You know what I'm saying? So what ends up happening? Here we go. All right, now. Well, never mind, man. That do enough.
All right. So. All right, well, I appreciate you. Hold on. Hello? Let me find out it was Leah. All right, say something real quick, too
much. Yeah, man, I'm all good. No, it's Leah.
It was Leah. It was Leah. Okay, finish what you was about to say, too much, and then we go.
Yeah, the insecurity issue is, you know, like her wanting everything to be perfect, her wanting to be misfixed, her, you know, she feel bad if she don't answer perfect. Bro, ain't nobody perfect, man, and it's all good. You dealing with a nigga that's going to embrace you with your flaws. And that's the best thing for you right now, I say, dealing with a man like that. You know what I'm saying? He can help you through that. But just chill the fuck out. You know what I'm saying? You're a beautiful woman. You know what I mean? You're intelligent. You got good hustle. Just keep pushing. Quit feeling so responsible for everything to be shits and rain. And you'll be all
right. Right. And let me say this real quick, you know, and I'm not trying to continue to bring up Yetta or anything like that, but since everybody on the app know who Yetta is, I only can use her as an example, not a comparison for you to her. However, I knew how Yetta looked, and that didn't stop me to building with her who was in that gym. I knew how somebody else looked that was recently with me, and that didn't stop me, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, you got to really want it, because some people say they want a man like me to show them and to be stern and to have that structure behind them, but then they start giving up gas. They start coming, hitting the live button, saying, oh, he's not feeding me, or, you know what I'm saying, I don't like to go to work out in the morning, and then they give up on me and make it seem like I'm sitting over here trying to change them when they actually say that they want that change. So if I was building with you, would you want me to give you that structure to get you together?
Absolutely.
Okay. All right. As long as you allow me to lead. And that's why I say, because I'm not here to try to force nobody. I'm not here to try to downgrade nobody. I'm not trying to bash nobody or anything like that. But if you have an insecurity, that can cause an issue, right? So if that can cause an issue, I'd rather help you and build you. I'm not here to break you down. But you got to allow me. And it's going to be difficult at times. It's going to be challenging. So as long as you allow me, I'm here. I'm in your corner. You know, if we was building with each other on that level. So, all right. So, I think that's all the questions. And I appreciate having you. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate having you. All right, baby?
All right. Thank you for having me.
All righty, tea time. All right. Leah, what was you saying? Echo.
Oh, she gone. Somebody was saying that they wanted us to ask her who somebody named. What's the name in the comments I had seen?
Wingard.
Yeah, who was Wingard? She fucking on Wingard.
I don't know.
She giving Wingard money.
Mac out, Calvin.
Was Wingard the bum that was living on anyway?
That's her man.
Who the fuck? She need to bring her ass back up here.
Do you mind come up here real quick? Because
that's what I want to ask.
Okay, hold on. Got a lot of echo. I'm pretty sure she can clarify that on her own. Come up here real quick, Hazel, if you can. Not if you can, but can you? All right, thank you. All right, so can you please address that for me, Queen?
Wingard is not my man. I've never met him in real life. Before the poly auditions, yes, I was talking to Wingard. I played for my pussy for him.
You said you pledged your pussy to him?
Mm-hmm.
You pledged? What does that mean?
I played with my pussy for him.
You know what? Thank you for being honest. I gotta respect that though. They did call your T out, but you owned it like a real one, and I gotta respect it. I know that would have turned off a lot of people, but I respect honesty more than anything. Little freaky girl, I fuck with it because you were honest about it. because you was honest about it. You know, I played with my dick a few times. You know, to some of these helpers. So at the end of the day, you know, she kept it real.
And he's not my man.
Because she went above and beyond. She didn't just say, I know Wingard. She said, oh, yeah, I know Wingard. I play with my pussy to him. Hey, you got to respect it. I don't know what else I can say.
See, I knew I liked you. I love a freak hoe. I like playing with my pussy on FaceTime, too.
Well,
I'm going to inbox you my number.
That's the truth. I'm not going to lie about it. That's what it is. He's not my man.
Okay, I don't want to be too invasive, but I'm only asking so I can get a timeline. Was it this month that you played with your pussy for him?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, we just started in April. Okay, that's honest. Oh, that's honest. That's
Morgan
Singer,
girl.
Honest.
Look how mad they all love it.
Does anybody want to?
I'm so mad. You should have said the beginning of this. You should have.
Anybody else want to? You know what? I appreciate you. I appreciate you for coming up here.
I was single, so I mean, y'all can say whatever.
I find it weird that you said that you're looking for the right man, but you're on the fucking live.
You sound like a bitch.
Pussy. Hold on. You're very argumentative.
Yeah, I don't want to talk.
I don't want to argue with her. Can you mute her? I don't want to argue with her. I'm not trying to argue with her. I just wanted to say something. Thank you, love. I just find it very weird that you sat on here, and a lot of these judges asked you about knowing when the right guy, even TKO sat there and paused you and was like, so what's the right guy? Like, how do you know? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what? And you didn't really give us, but this month, currently, recently, you were fucking on a beer belly, pot belly, woman abuser with no teeth who lives with his brother in a basement. So that's your time. It seems like you don't make the best decisions, and I see why. You're too busy trying to prove your point and not focusing on what the point is in life. I have nothing to say to her. I want the next woman. She's bored me. I almost fall asleep, literally.
Okay. I'm going to give her a chance.
You don't make the best decisions either, bitch. You like to fuck on 17-year-olds. Let's talk about it. I'm single. I could play with my pussy for who I want to.
Period. And you know what? I feel like late night is a bit jaded when it comes to pretty light-skinned women, because the last pretty light-skinned woman he was around smelled like a puppy and was bullying him, and she exposed the fact that he likes 17-year-olds. So don't take it personal. Them baby hairs and that light skin and them pretty eyes is triggering to him. Okay? Don't take it personal.
Okay, so we're going to...
Wait, you're the wrong girl.
All right, well, thank you. Thank you, Hazel, for coming back up here when called or summoned. That's one thing I do respect. So, you ask those questions. You know,
He literally looks like this, like a bitch. Like, get the fuck out of my...
He's literally attacking you. When he's supposed to be asking questions.
Shut your ass up. I'm about to attack you. Shut up. But next,
nigga, where am I?
Attack your cases.
No, you're only exposing that you sound more of a fan about me. Let me find out you watch me a lot too. You like me too?
I never watched you a day in my life. Oh. I don't even know who you
so are. you know all this about me, but you don't know watch me.
You were so quick to bring up Wingard.
Yeah, I think you're for the Beagle Streets. You should stay there. I don't think TKO wants a person that talks a lot and gossips and does what you've been portraying. But that's my opinion.
Nobody even knows me on Beagle.
And clearly, somebody knows what your pussy looks like. They know what your pussy looks like.
Yeah, they do. You can find it on JustStars.com also.
Hold on.
I love her.
Hold on.
Is she the one?
I wasn't ready.
The audition is over.
Tell me, where can we find this pussy? You said you got OnlyFans and Snapchat Premium and shit?
No, the broke nigga that she's fucking called Wingard has his own porn site because he's so broke he has to scam people. Be quiet. I mean, my playing with the pussy. The broke nigga that she's playing with. No.
One at a time, y'all. One at a time. I can't hear nobody. All right, so go ahead, Hazel. Say your part, then it's late night next. Go ahead.
Playing with my little fat kitty. You can find it on JustStars.com/Hazel. Pay $200 for it, okay? And that's about it. What else do you gotta say?
It's called Just Stars. I'm not gonna do it because I don't look up people's pussies.
You don't have to do it. I'll send it to you for free, daddy.
Oh. Okay. Next, thank you for that charitable donation. Gelling gesture. Go ahead, late night.
Okay, and please keep that squirrel in number 5 muted too. See, I think you're more of a prettier version of Moet. You're just a pretty version of Moet. So here's my thing. The Just Stars website that you just said is the website that the broke nigga with no teeth that lives in the basement, the guy that you played with his pussy, his name's Wingard, that's his website that he created because he scams a bunch of little weak-minded and, you know, you're not even confident enough to show your body.
Hold on. Yes, this is true.
I speak only facts. This is facts. Hold on. This is facts. What'd you say?
Yeah, that's true. He tried to get me on his website.
Okay, so look, my thing is, this fat loser decide it tries to get women like her. She just says she's insecure. She does. What is an insecure woman doing on a website showing anything? Does that even sound correct? So he fools women like this to think that, oh, get on my website, let me make some money. That's the only reason why women he has news. No women really like him. He fools women to make him think that they're gonna make money off his website while they download his website and put their pussy for free while he just plays with his pecker downstairs and watches comic books. You don't have the best decisions. You're for the Beagle Streets, and TKO, you're about to be a grown man and a father, and you got so much going on. I would hate to have a pretty version of Moet coming around and just causing havoc. But I've said enough. She's so insecure about her body. She's on a porn site. Okay. She makes a lot of sense.
Okay. So I ain't gonna lie. That is breaking news. I'm kind of glad that we had this conversation tonight because that is breaking news to me. Like, I do respect your honesty, but I'm kind of asking myself, was you being so honest because you knew that was public tea and it was going to get out anyway? So you just kind of like curved it. You kind of just went ahead and went ahead because you already knew. And is this his site? Because I'm trying to understand why you didn't just go to fucking OnlyFans, which is bigger and probably even more traffic than going on. Like, you're damn near supporting this dude. And I'm not hating on it, but I'm just saying, no. Is this his?
Go ahead. Can I rebuttal when you're done? Shut, if it's late night, shut the fuck up. I don't want to talk to you. Don't talk to me. The difference between that is when you have subscribers on OnlyFans, okay? They can see everything, right? When you put explicit videos,
let me answer your question. You asked me a question, right? So when you actually, that's not true. So when you have subscribers, you got special things to where you can actually lock it while you're on it. Just because you subscribe doesn't mean you can see everything that you post on OnlyFans. I'm on that.
Well, I didn't know that information.
Okay. Sure.
But I'm selling my explicit videos for $200, $500.
So, okay. Thank you for that extra information. But I just want to know the question that I asked you. Are you selling your pussy on his site? You selling your pussy, not just selling your pussy, but you get what I'm saying? Selling your nudes and stuff on his site that he created.
He doesn't own it. Does he own the website? It's like OnlyFans.
They're saying he owned it, baby. Was you not aware? Where?
I know this because they both have conversations with me about it. They tried to get me in on there so bad.
It's him and his partner Smitch. That's who owned the website. He even wanted me to be on it.
He the co-owner. Okay. Well, yes, like he owned it, so that's like his movement.
But like she just admitted, she didn't even know that she could make exclusive content. That was the reason that she did it. She's naive, like I said. He takes advantage of women who don't even know what they're talking about and finesses them into getting into the thing and make him money. Close.
I don't think so. I think everybody can make a judge. I think everybody decides on what they want.
No, I think you were. I think you're not. You didn't know what you're talking about. You just said, "Ma'am, let me be honest with you." You just said that the reason why you're on that website is because the reason why you're on that website is because you can have exclusive content and people have access to it. If that's the reason, then you were not told correctly. You were not taught correctly. You did not have your information. So that means you were not knowledgeable of what you said. So you were taken advantage of. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You didn't know what you were talking about. And he knew. As a porn star who's creating websites, why would he not know?
How can he take advantage of me if
I just told you. I'm going off your statements. You just said the reason why you signed up for his site was because that you can have exclusive content and OnlyFans didn't allow. And then we corrected you, who I was also signed to an OnlyFans agency. I would never sign to his. He tried to grab me. But the information is correct. You just didn't have it. You can do exclusive content and price it at whatever you want. Not everyone has access to your things. You can lock things on your OnlyFans. So what I'm trying to say to you is because you didn't have that knowledge, he has that knowledge. He did not share that knowledge to you. He just fed you the knowledge of that you know, and now you ended up on his site, aka taken advantage of, because you can make way more money on OnlyFans. There's about 20 girls on his website, and they're all from Bego, and they're all trash.
Well, can I say this? I'm okay with being on just stars, and I don't have any problem with Win God, and I'm good with it.
That's good.
Okay, so let me ask you this. Thank you, Late Night, for that extra information. So let me ask you this real quick. I can't front. I respect your honesty, but I can't front about put like this. If I told you to get you know, to remove yourself and not to talk to this dude no more. And you was my woman. As my woman, would you have any problems, any hesitations with doing that? As my
woman? Not at all. Absolutely not.
Okay. Okay.
As your woman. No.
Okay. Okay. Do you think that you owe, and this is a, it can sound like a trick question, but just listen before you answer, okay? Mm-hmm. With you being a woman that's very interested in me and potentially picking up, like moving from Miami to come to Vegas to build with me and my family, do you think you have any type of, not obligation, but something that's less than the word obligation to carry yourself in a certain type of way, even though that you're technically single?
Absolutely.
And how would that look?
It would look bad if I carried myself in any other way that you asked for.
No, I don't think. Okay. All right. No, I don't think you understood the question. It's okay, because I'm not trying to get caught up in the semantics of things.
She made me clap and then fucked it up.
Okay.
She made me clap and then fucked it up. I'm over this. Okay, my bad. Go ahead. I'm going to mute myself.
Well, thank you, Hazel. I think this is this has most definitely been a really good conversation tonight. And like, you never know what you're going to get on the Poly Auditions. And thank you once again for being honest, because at least I feel like I can trust you by asking you something and you being honest with me. So that means a lot. Yeah, you may do some shit that I may not agree, but you at least I know if I ask you something, you're going to keep it real with me and you ain't going to dumb it down. So now I don't know if you're going to comprehend everything, but when I ask you something directly, at least you're not going to dumb down what you're asking. So I do respect that. You keep looking at the comments, but I'm
can you repeat the last question that you asked me for me?
Wow. Okay. All right. Be patient. So hold on, Leah. Let me just get the... Go ahead, Leah.
Did you ask her to spell stuff like you did the other ones? Because I want to see if she know how to spell.
I don't think. Hold on.
Leah, I think I'm drinking the same wine you are, baby. But yeah, we can find it. Let's go. Give it to me.
I think she can spell.
Let's spell.
You think she can spell? Let's spell? Okay. Only because it's fair.
Gynecologist. She didn't know what the normal pH balance is for women. She should spell gynecologist.
G-Y-N-E-C-O-L-I-G-Y-N-E.
I'm not in charge. I was just suggesting that.
Yeah, so shut the fuck up, punk.
No, that was actually a good word. I asked TKO. You started out right, baby. Can you spell gynecologist? Cause you started out right, but you, go ahead on, say it again.
Gynecologist, G Y N E C O L E G I. Wait, hold on.
One more time.
Gyno, G Y N O.
No.
L-O-G-I-S-T.
No. You just... Okay. It's okay. I'm going to give you an easier word.
No, don't give me an easier word.
Can you spell alcoholic? Alcoholic.
Of course I can spell that. A-L-C-H-O-L-I-C. Alcoholic.
Okay.
And she repeat the word twice. She didn't put in the spelling bee.
What does
pH stands for in a pH balance? What that?
Oh, it was wrong. I thought she spelled alcoholic again. I thought I heard it. I thought she spelled it right. Say it again.
I thought she spelled it right too.
Yeah, I thought she spelled it right.
A L C H O L.
Oh.
I see.
Start over again. No. She left out something. Say it one more time. Alcoholic.
A-L-C-O.
She's missing an I.
Alco. No, I'm not.
You got it, baby. Go ahead. One more time. Alcoholic. You got it, baby.
Please stop, TK. I can't take no more of this.
No, she dumb. No, she got good genetics, though. You know what I'm saying? She's